Vinoba, a Portrait Sketch by Hallam Tennyson. The summary of Vinoba, a Portrait Sketch. Vinoba is the embodiment of India. He started a new kind of pilgrimage. He used to wake up at 4 and walk from one village to another along with his followers and an ox cart. In ox cart there were typewriters, stationery, a filing cabinet along with their beddings. The purpose of their pilgrimage is to collect land from the landlords for the landless peasants. He collected 1 million acres of land in 2 years for the landless peasants. His target was 50 million acres of land. The land gifts mission started in 1951 in Hyderabad. On his way to Hyderabad, he came face to face with the misery of the landless peasants. He went to an area where communist agitators were murdering landlords and appealed to the landlords to treat him as one of their sons and give his share of property. His appeal touched their imagination. They gave him land and the land gifts mission was born like that. In this 2 months stay in Hyderabad, he received nearly 12,000 acres in trust of the landless. On his way to Delhi, he received 18,000 acres. In 2 years, he had collected not less than 1 million acres of land as free gift for landless peasants. Vinoba lived in seclusion in a village in central India. He was leading a new kind of pilgrimage. At that time, the writer Tennyson met him. Vinoba looked much older than his 57 years of age. He was a great scholar and good mathematician. The writer couldn't understand why he had renounced everything and chosen such a simple life. Renunciation of worldly possessions echoes in every Hindu heart and in old age. They threw up everything and retired to die in hut by the gangs, but Vinoba reserved it. Instead of leading a retired life, he took up social service at the age. Vinoba followed Gandhiji. Vinoba had only a spinning wheel and some homespun clothes for his possessions. He refused the offer of motor cars because the farmers cannot afford them. He had a chronic duodenal ulcer and subject to dysentery, but these didn't stop him from doing service to the poor. When he had malaria, he refused to be treated with quinine because poor peasants couldn't afford it. Vinoba won over the landlords by touching their conscience. He approached them in a spirit of loving conciliation. He refused anything less than 1/6 of the best property of the landlord. Vinoba learnt 16 languages to converse more freely with anyone. Vinoba acquired his strength through renunciation. At the age of 10, he took a vow of chastity which he has kept up throughout. At the age of 20, when he joined Gandhiji's rural center, he burnt all his certificates and diplomas. He was confident that his work would succeed. His attitude to work was that one should attend to one's duty without worrying about what the result would be. Like fire, which burns without caring to know whether anyone put a pot on it, filled it with water and put rice in it to make a meal. They woke up at 3:30 a.m. and by 4 o'clock a.m. they assembled for prayers and silent spinning. In half an hour, they set off on foot for their next stopping place. At daybreak, they have roadside breakfast. Meanwhile, Vinoba listens to the problems of the crowd that gathers. By 10 a.m., the party reaches the village. Vinoba summons the local landlords. He explains to them the need to give the peasants their rights. In the evening, the landlords themselves are made to declare how much land they are ready to give. he sets up a village committee to look to the cultivation of the distributed land. Vinoba avoids publicity. He has his own dignity, emphasis and methods. He rarely speaks of Gandhiji in public. He has dedicated his life to the service his fellow human beings, and he believes to see the God in them. Thank you, friends. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe us for more videos.